and good morning from Proactive New York. Joining me today from GreenBank Capital, CEO Terry Pullen. Terry, good to see you. How are you?
Yeah, very well, Christine. And yes, my pleasure to be with you again. So thank you for the invitation.
Of course, it's great to have you back. Terry, GreenBank's portfolio company, Staminier's subsidiary Substantia, will invest in a tech firm that's called Identify. So maybe first explain what exactly Identify does.
Certainly, yes. Identify is a user-friendly platform that really makes compliance easy and simple. And in today's world of identification being critical to many, many businesses, to us as individuals, and the world over, we believe that an end-to-end tech that is then delivered into a product that delivers a service, as it's been brought to us, we're very excited about it, and it's something that we don't believe is out there in the end-to-end form that we have. Consequently, we believe that it's a unique opportunity.
Before we talk more about how the tech kind of works, can you tell me a bit more about its founder, Samshur Singh?
Certainly. Well, at GreenBank, as we've discussed before, the best ideas in the world can only ever be brought forward by quality people who have, yes, got good ideas, got good character, got good values, and frankly, have got the ability to work hard back and forward with the challenges that come from the delivery of good ideas. Samsha, is a young, highly motivated, ambitious man who has got an unusual ability to marry up great presentation skills with also technical knowledge and entrepreneurial sort of abilities. And they're things that at GreenBank and Substantia, we really look for. Because truly, some of the best ideas in the world are never going to be delivered if the people behind them don't have the values and the drive and the persistence required to take things forward. So no, we believe we've got a great package with ideas and the human element with Samshir.
That's definitely true. In the best way that you can you explain how the technology leverages blockchain and NFTs to secure documents?
We certainly can, and I'm not the best tech person, but I would do my best to. the blockchain model, which is obviously used in lots of different applications, is critical to secure the fundamental process of security. There the world over, there are literally billions of fraudulent applications around identity and identification on a daily basis. It really is a terrible problem. And because it's such a problem, there's many industries the world over, but I'll pick one, which is the healthcare industry. And the healthcare industry is something that relies on the security of people being who they say they are. It's as simple as that. Our tech enables to go, as I said, from end to end using blockchain and the NFT sort of process to truly identify individuals in a way that will be unique. Consequently, people will have the ability to effectively have the app and store all of their unique identification criteria in one place. Businesses will have the ability to be able to check into that application, use that application to use the different levels of process to actually get the identification to the point whereby they will know 99.9% that person is who that person says they are. And that's not able to be done at the moment across a range of identification processes. KYC is out there, but not to the level that we're talking about.
You mentioned healthcare. What are some other areas that you can target here?
Yeah, logistics and pretty much all other areas. We've spoke before, Christine, about the way that the pandemic has changed so many different businesses, so many different services the world over. And there's so many businesses and people now that are fluid. You know, they are mobile, they are self-employed, they are people that are in that gig economy that frankly, you know, may not even have a permanent place of abode. They don't have permanent addresses. How do they prove where they, who they are without a permanent place of address? It's very difficult. So that's just one small part of a gap that we can cover with this, apart from the other end of the gap that, frankly, you get sort of older people like me who get really frustrated with having to go to the airport with loads of bits of paper. I can have everything in one place from, you know, the sort of the COVID, you know, passport, you know, through to my passport, my, you know, and my driver's license. Just a, you know, three clicks of a button can all be in one place.
I know you've just announced the investment here, but do you have a timeline in mind of when this tech could be commercialized?
Absolutely. We're looking towards getting the first round of product in 4 months' time. That'd be 4 months from the beginning of May. From that 4 months, we will then have a situation where we believe that we'll be going to market the back end of this year for Q1 in 23.
All right. We look forward to progress you make here. Terry, thanks so much for the time. I appreciate it.
Thank you, Christine.